This is a day one message, assuming that you were successful in logging into the course online. You're going to be able to see this page, and let me tell you what I would like you to do on the first day of classes. As I stated in a different video, I want you to try to explore the course shell and navigate the course menu, and in particular the course information, to read the syllabus and see how you're going to be graded in this course along with some other information. But when it gets, you know, to start the class, I would like you to start your interactive assignment. You're going to see the chapters. You're going to begin with chapter one, and I put a due date in there. I do expect you to finish this chapter in a matter of couple days. This is a very short chapter, so this is chapter one, and this is what you're going to be learning in the chapter. There are four sections, and they're very short sections. You're going to click on section 1.1 right here to begin interacting with the textbook online and doing the homework. But what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to give you a summary of what you're going to be learning. For each chapter, on the cover page or the main page of the chapter, I'm going to include the detailed objectives. So make sure that you master those objectives before you move on to a second one. So the first chapter is going to be about the definition of statistics and tell you what statistics is about. And then we're going to talk about variables and define variables and distinguish between a qualitative and quantitative. Quantitative means a number and qualitative means an attribute. For example, favorite color is qualitative, but number of students in my class is quantitative. Distinguish between discrete and continuous variable. You're going to learn what it means to have a discrete variable continuous and the difference between the two. For example, on the test, I might give you a variable and ask you what does it represent, a discrete or a continuous. If you know the definition, you should be able to tell what the variable is. You're going to learn the level of measurements of a variable. There are four levels of measurements, so you will learn under what level of measurement a variable falls in. And then you're going to learn about sampling techniques. Why do we do a sample in statistics? Why don't we study the entire population? There's what we call a simple random sample, and then stratified sample, systematic sample, and cluster sample. For example, on the test, I will give you a sampling technique and I'll ask you, what is it? Is it a simple random sample, a stratified, a systematic, or a cluster? I'll give you an example and then I'll ask you to say what type of sampling here. At the very end, you're going to learn about the source of bias in sampling. And once you learn about this, you're going to be suspicious of anything you see, especially ads on TVs and commercials, that you're going to suspect that there is a bias, you know, in those samples, which is a true fact. So this is what chapter one is about. And to begin chapter one, you're going to click on section 1.1 right here. You always have to do the read and interact. I put some animation here to just flavor the text a little bit, so feel free to enjoy and reading. And some of the stuff that I put here, I propose a question which you will be able to answer after you read the text. Well, actually, it's not reading, it's reading and interacting. You're gonna see a lot of videos, a lot of built-in exercises inside the text, so I'm hoping that there will be a fun course to learn and enjoy. After you finish the read and interact assignment, and you have to make sure that you get at least 70% on an interactive assignment before you can do the homework. You will not be able to access the homework if you get less than 70% on the interactive assignment. Once you do that, you will do the same thing for section 1.3, section 1.4, and section 1.5. As you can see, there's an icon next to section 1.2 here. You won't see that, but it means that this is a hidden section, so you don't have to worry about. So this is what you would do for section 1.1, and once you do section 1.1, you finish section 1.1, you will do the same thing with section 1.3 and so on and so forth. Welcome again to the course, and do expect lots of messages from me, mainly in a voice format or text format. This is an interactive course, and I will try to interact with you in different ways, such as like via audio messages, video messages, and text messages. Let me know if any questions.